Abdurrahman.
Surah Al-Kushi from chapter 5, verse 39.
539.
The moment your turn comes, the Imam Sahib immediately gets the Quran and it lying next to him.
It has become a reflex for Imam
Sahib. Yes, reflex for him, yes. Correct.
So this is verse number 35 from Surah Al-Ma'idah, which is chapter number 39. Yes, verse number 39 from Surah Al-Ma'idah, which is chapter number 5 of the Holy Quran. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Was-sariqu was-sariqatu faqta'u aydiyahuma jazam bima kasaba nakalam minallah wallahu azizun hakim. And as for the man who steals and the women who steals, cut off their hands in retribution of their offense as an exemplary punishment from Allah. And Allah is mighty, wise.
Huzur, why is it not applied today in any Muslim country except Saudi Arabia? Is that the question?
Also, it seems appears cruel.
We'll turn to the cruelty point later on. First of all, it is not applied to most of the Muslim countries. Why? Because if it were applied in Pakistan, entire Pakistan will be one-handed. Almost all of it. But perhaps it will be a different picture altogether. Only those who do not steal, their hands will be cut off. Because those who do not steal, most often they do not lie either. And those who steal, they also lie. So all the liars of Pakistan will gang up against two people who do not steal. Their hands should be cut off and get rid of them in the society. It is not applicable because it's not practical anymore. The Quran is addressing a society whose moral status had already been raised, who had learned from Ahazur sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be true and honest, and who had learned from the society that their daily needs were met with by the many systems in Islam which were in circulation, which were practically implied. Zakat, etc., the caliph roaming the streets to see if there's anybody hungry or not. All these things were possible or made possible before this injunction was released. So in a society which takes care of all your basic economic needs, in a society which knows no lies, and the majority of the people are habitually truthful, such injunction is applicable. And there it will not look cruel at all, because the entire atmosphere would demand such a thing. And it would be cruel to the society if they are not treated like this. Why is man granted hands to earn his living? Those who cannot, the state takes care of them. So they apply their hands to counter the principle of Islamic economy. Hands are granted to you to earn your living. If you use your hands to counter this principle and destroy the principle of handsomely and honorably earn your own livelihood, then these hands are useless. And it should be demonstrated to the society that the hands which were granted by God for a set purpose were employed to counter that purpose. Such hands must go. and they will be a reminder to the rest of the society that you be honest and mindful of your responsibility. Such cases will be far and few between, because there are conditions also laid on this. Sariq wa sariq wa sariqa, they do not mean if somebody saraqa. It means if somebody is a habitual sariq. So another condition is imposed on applying this law. The thief should be a regular thief, not one who occasionally stole a mouthful of something or this and that. That should have been expressed in the Quran by verbs, not by nouns. So as against the verb of saraqa, Allah employed the noun of as-sariq, which means a habitual thief, a professional thief. So then the ugliness which appears to some is further reduced in a society where you do not need to steal at all. If there are habitual thieves found, then they must be destroyed. And the society should get rid of all such evil happenings. So in my opinion, this is the best teachings to stop stealing. And the price you pay for not employing this is the one which even the entire Western countries are paying nowadays. In the name of courtesy or kindness to the criminal, they are being absolutely unkind to the law-abiding people, to the innocent. The daily mugging and robbing and breaking of the houses which you encounter these days in England alone is a rising problem, which is very difficult, if not impossible, for them to handle. Now, how many innocent people are maimed by the thieves? Imagine that. Every year, so many hands of innocent people are cut off by the thieves, who while running away, they, you know, slash at the hands of the people. Only the other day I read this news item that a man was deprived of both his hands by a thief while he was trying to chase him. He slashed back and cut the both hands off. So is this a better society? Where is kindness and justice, not to criminals, but kindness and justice to the ordinary citizens who are not criminals? So the tables are turned exactly to a position where ugliness roams the streets of every foreign free country, and nobility feels shy of walking in the streets. So you turn the tables and then see the converse, and you have to return to the Islamic teaching. There's the only guarantee for establishing true peace and honesty and justice in the society, and to make a society worth living. In an Islamic society such as these, such as this described in the Quran, I'm sure no locks would be needed. That is why the Holy Quran says, if you have some property in your house which does not belong to you, but you have the right to have your property, knock at the door, and if you don't hear Islam, you walk in. If there were locks employed, how could anyone walk in with the property lying unprotected? So one should notice that mention in the Quran of, you know, where Assalamu Alaikum is necessary before you enter a house. In the same place it is mentioned that if you have some valuables lying in a house which does not belong to you, so knock at the door. If there is the people who own that house, the dwellers of the house, if they answer, well and good. But if nobody answers, just walk in. That means no bolts are employed, no locks, not at all. And the valuables are there. So this is the ideal society Islam wants to create. And it was created in those days, otherwise such injunctions could not have been revealed. Got it? Yes, please.